Hello and welcome to another stream. My name is Ray and it is Learning Korean with Ray. Day 206. Yeah, thanks for tuning in. Hi Flo, welcome to the stream. Yeah, sadly I'm 5 minutes late today. But we'll just learn anyways. Yeah, yesterday again didn't manage to finish up the lesson. Was another pretty big vocabulary review. Today we have another pretty big vocabulary review. But no, the main problem was that we always discussed a lot, so we only managed to do one or two little chapters. But we have only one little chapter left in the grammar lesson, so this time we'll definitely finish up the lesson and go into the workbook and then some recap videos from previous lessons. But before we start with that, we will do this review. I will try to be as fast as possible here. 46 words. Let's go. Okay, first of all, I need to change my sound and my keyboard layout, and now I stopped. Okay, younger sister. Yo dongsaeng.
여동생.
Na jung e do pwa yo.
나중에 또 봐요.
Yokshik. Yokshi, right?
역시.
Yeah. To go out. Nagada.
나가다.
Tail. Gori. Gore. Ah, mistype. Go.
Gori.
Gori was correct. Nice. Below is meat.
Meat.
Disappointed. Silmanghada.
Silmanghada.
Grandmother. Halmoni.
Halmoni.
Jigum.
Jigum.
Wow. To get off, go down, come down. I don't think I know this. Is this one of the compound words or not? I'm not sure. I don't know this.
내리다.
Ah, 내리다. Yeah, okay. 내리다.
내리다.
To come out, 나오다.
나오다.
Perfectly. One. John. He.
완전히.
완전히. 친구.
친구.
남동생.
남동생.
P.
B.
중동. Sit up da. Jock, jock, jock. Ah, man. Okay, then it's Chung.
Chungdongjok.
That's it. Okay. Older sister, when speakers male, Nuna.
Nuna.
Aunt paternal. Komo.
Komo.
Hey Kaya, thanks for tuning in. Older brother who speaks male, Hyung.
Hyung.
Hyung. 가스레인지
가스레인지
가스레인지 아 조시
아저씨
죽
쪽
curious was this is Kungim, right? Kungim Hada? Kungim.
궁금하다.
There we go. Imo.
이모.
비밀.
비밀.
발다.
팔다.
할아버지. 할아버지. Definitely seems correct.
할아버지
Yeah. Picture, 사진.
사진
가게.
가게
오리?
오리
Time, when? This is a weird.
때
Yeah, day, okay. Lifestyle. Ah, uncle, something with sing. Hua, hue, huek, sing. But to be honest, I don't know.
생활,
생활. Okay.
생활,
오왈. 생황, 생활. 오케이. 안경.
안경,
사다.
사다.
떠나다.
떠나다.
싫어하다.
싫어하다.
건너다. I think. 건너다. 건너다.
건너다.
There we go. All the system will speak as female. 언니. 언니.
언니.
Uncle, 사촌, 촌, 삼촌.
삼촌.
점점.
점점.
To change. 웃다. To change. Change. Something with like botta. Ah, damn, I don't know.
바꾸다,
바꾸다, okay.
바꾸다.
Lifestyle, 생황, 활, 생활.
생활,
내리다.
내리다.
내부 and 외부.
외부.
Okay, nice. 동생.
동생.
바꾸다.
바꾸다.
케 something 케 관 관케 관 관케 관 관계
관계 관계
오케이 well 18 more let's do it a little 조금
조금
of course 뭘 물론
물론
물론 to retire 퇴 퇴 is it job 하다 퇴직
퇴직하다 퇴직하다
some only with those people 몇몇
몇몇
surely 꼭
꼭
좀 참 Pretty sure it was something with this. Maybe not. Hmm. Oh wait, 꿈꾸다 is to dream, right? 꿈, it's 꿈.
꿈.
Yeah, nice. Oh. 새 상.
세상.
순수하다. 순수하다.
순수하다.
순수하다. 늘다. 늘리다.
늘리다.
남편. 남편. 아우, mistype. 남편.
남편.
Repeatedly. Oh, this one is hard. Ah, wait, Jagu, right?
Jagu.
Jaju, Jagu. Okay, nice. Or. Donen. Kinanhada. Kananada. Kananda? Kananhada? Wasn't it Kananada? Oh, wait. Poor. Ah, never mind. That is to be poor. Poorly, of course, is mot.
Mot.
To request. Yochong. 하다.
요청하다.
드물다. 드물다.
드물다.
기름.
기름.
색깔.
색깔.
색깔. To call out. 부르다.
부르다.
To be dark. 어둠. 어둡다.
어둡다.
Okay. Nice. Very 매우.
매우.
To receive. So 수접하다. Job 수하다. Job 수하다.
접수하다.
새 경. 새. Oh, I don't know. 아니, 세상.
세계. 세계.
오케이.
세계. 세계.
세. 세계.
세계. 세계.
Okay. Yeah, we'll finish this. Okay. So, with that, we go into the grammar. Lesson 21, where we learned how to build questions without question words for formal situations, simnika, for females, ni, for adjectives in present tense, nga, and for verbs, nayo, or na, just na. And now, then we learned question words. We use them as an adverb most of the time, like where. And we also replace any place. Yeah, any place in a sentence from a normal sentence with onje to ask where, to ask for that place. When and okay, so this was a placing and this was the time, of course. So we replace a place, or we replace a time specification. And now the only thing that's left is nagu, nugu. But I want to just go over these other question words one more time, because they were some special things. Okay, so why is just used as an adverb. Okay, all good. But on J, when? Ah yeah, we had this part with puto or kaji. Until when? Since when? Stuff like that. Whenever. Okay, and then we had the same for this one, where you can add kaji, but not puto, because puto is not used for places that often. So only kaji. And yeah, that's basically it. Ah yeah, oh yeah, yeah, the ida as well. Or the yao, if you ask for you or a specific place. But if you ask for persons or objects, you use ita. And then you... Okay, this is the only thing that I also forgot. The e. The e is interesting, because you can use it without the a as well, but you can also add a so. So that's a bit weird and difficult for me. Sometimes you put an A afterwards, sometimes you don't, sometimes you put a so. So that is still something that I will be struggling with in the future. So yeah, that's how it is. And for when, that was not the case. For when, we don't put an A after that, right? We just always use onj, or we attach kaji, for example, or puto. Okay. And also we can add ida. When is the wedding? When is this vacation? Okay. Enough reviewing. I hope I can remember all of it. And now we go into nugu. In Korean, nugu has the function of a pronoun. Actually, some of the ways you use onj and od in Korean are pronouns. I chose not to explain this to you because of the definition of a pronoun in Korean and English is not exactly the same. Okay. Onj and od can act as pronouns in Korean, but the same usage would be called an adverb in English. Okay. I actually had an explanation typed out, but decided to not include it into this lesson because it makes things more confusing than they actually are. However, knowing that nugu is a pronoun in English and Korean is helpful. If you know what pronouns are. As a pronoun, nugu can be used in a place of a noun in a sentence. That is, it can be used to replace an object, subject, it can be used to replace the object, the subject, or as a noun before ida. I mean, the other ones, onj and od, also replace nouns, basically. For example, od replacing specific places. The places are nouns as well, right? But let's see some examples here. This is the same in English, as you can see in the following three examples. Who will study Korean tomorrow? Who is the subject of the sentence? Who will you meet tomorrow? Who is the object? You is the subject. Who is that person in the sentence? What? Who is that person? Who is that person? That person is... Okay. This is confusing in English because all the three cases, who is the first word of the sentence, regardless of its role. In Korean, instead of always placing who at the start of the sentence, it should be placed in the location of the subject, the object, or before ida. I will show you an example of each. In the third sentence below, you can see an example of nugu being used as a subject. The subject is underlined in each case. When nugu is used as a subject of a sentence, it is changed to nuga. Oh wow, it changes. Damn. Okay. You will study Korean tomorrow. Okay, nonin is the subject. Will you study? Okay, still, this is the subject. Okay. Who will study Korean tomorrow? Nuga. Nuga 내일 한국어를 공부할 거야.
누가 내일 한국어를 공부할 거야?
Okay. And here we can use, as we can see the usage as an object, I mean. Who will you meet tomorrow? Okay, so I think you can remember that by just you asking the or saying the English normal sentence, but also replace the thing you're asking for with who. So, for example, you will study tomorrow. Who will study tomorrow? So you is replaced with who. But here you can do the same. You will meet a friend tomorrow. You will meet who tomorrow? Right? It's understandable for English speakers anyways. It's not the grammatical correct sentence to ask that question, but you can definitely understand, excuse me, you will meet who tomorrow? That's definitely a valid way to say that, I think. And with that, you can actually remember the Korean usage, the correct grammatical Korean usage as well. Nonin neil nugure manal koya.
너는 내일 누구 만날 거야? 너는 내일 누구 만날 거야?
Oh, it almost sounds like Dugu. We have that discussion again.
너는 내일 누구 만날 거야?
너는 내일 누구? Damn. Nam.
너는 내일 누구 만날 거야?
Yeah, it's all these, just these everywhere. Oh man. Okay, in the third sentence below, you can see an example of Nugu being used before Ida. I don't hear any D.
너는 내일 누구 만날 거야? 너는 내일 누구 만날 거야?
Okay, so in the first, it's okay, but the third one here. It's definitely Dugu.
너는 내일 누구 만날 거야?
Man, can't I play this
너는 내일 누구
slower
만날
somehow?
거야?
Play speed. Yeah, slow. Let's see.
너는 내일 누구 만
If that is not a Dugu for you, I don't know what is. Okay. Slightly, but only after you played it slow. Yeah, okay, but you have to admit, if I play it slow and then you hear it, that just means that you misheard it when it was fast. That is not a good argument that it's not the case, you know? If the slower, if I play it slower, then the reality is more visible, right? Or hearable in this case. So if it's in the slow speed, if it's then a D, for example, then that means it's a D. And in the fast speed, if you don't hear the D, that only means you mishear it. Not that it's not a D. Anyways. Yeah, we'll just continue. That person is your dad. Who is that person? Kil Saramin Noe Abogia. Okay, you could really use the strategy that I mentioned before. That person is who? Yeah. 그 사람은 누구야?
그 사람은 누구야?
Oh.
그 사람은 누구야?
Okay, never mind. That's it for this lesson. But there are still lots of you to know about asking questions in Korean. This lesson covered the first half of what you need to know. The second or the following lesson will cover the rest. Okay. I want to go back to the very first beginning here. Yeah, okay, I just want to check this one again because I wasn't sure if I remember correctly, but you can just say the completely normal sentence with a different intonation to make it a question. Yeah. But then what is this? Okay, so is this just a special case? Yeah, this is just a special case of the first one, right? So you leave the sentence as it is, and you just change the intonation. But if it's a simnida, you have to change it. That's just like a specific case of the normal thing that we had here on top. You can, okay, here it's can, so I wanted to check that. Here you have to, you must use, and here you can. Also can. This was the adjective present tense, right? Yeah. So, and here, and this is the same for verbs. So, what I still don't know, what I would like to know is, what is the more common way to ask questions? Is it, for example, using, if we talk about adjectives, for example, is it this one? Or is it the very first one where we don't really change anything? Or is it depending on the sentence? So, because we learned we can just change the intonation and have the sentence just like it is a sentence without a question. Or we have the information that we can put stuff like na or nga. Depends on what people are talking. So you mean depends on the like formality or honorifics? For example, if one person needs a lot of respect or so, you use one, and if not, you use the other? Or what do you mean by people? Among friends, you don't try to make your questions softer. Okay. Okay, yeah, softer. Let me reread that part for each case. Also depends on how you want to seem to the listener, direct or more polite. Okay, I definitely have to review that part. What is more direct, what is softer? One second, let me try something here. I hope my streaming software doesn't crash. I will now copy this. No, I will not, never mind. Or will I? I will copy this text block here that I use for my YouTube videos. I will copy that and put it on this scene. Oh, actually, I have one already. Oh, nice. I have it here already. Okay, never mind then. So, soft or direct soft. Okay, here we have our direct to soft scale. Alignment goes to center. Had this problem last time as well. The alignment is not s center for direct. Anyways, so we have asking questions in Korean. So this one, is there any information about the softness or directness here? I think it starts here. Or in the next one it starts, I think. Ah, this is an informal way to ask you questions. Okay, but this is a knee. I will skip that. You can enter. This form is less formal than the high respect simniga. Where's the simniga again? I'm scrolling too fast. Nothing here about the softness or directness. I mean that this form is less formal is obvious because simnida is always the most formal one. So simniga is obviously also the most formal one. So this is not the problem. This is clear. Ah, here we have the information. Okay. This form makes it a little bit softer than using the form described previously. Okay, what does he mean with previously here in this case? So I will definitely put this one more on the softer scale here. Let's put it here for now. Would it be okay if I go to the park? Okay. So, but if you have a very formal situation, you still want to use this one, independent on the softness or directness, right? But is this one softer than the one where you don't add anything, where you just leave the sentence like it is and you just change the intonation? I think that's the case, right? So the intonation. Yeah, okay. Let me put it here, intonation change. Okay. So intonation change and n nothing else is the most direct one so far. I hope I got this right. The simniga we will ignore because that's just always the thing you used when you has had simnida, right? So we don't need to decide for that. Okay, here it can be used to make a question sound slightly softer than the other ways to ask a question. So, okay, but this is on the same level than the other one. Than this one, right? Just that this is for adjectives and this is for verbs. Okay, I see. We definitely have a problem here again. Simple text is not enough here. So, what do we do? And this is not enough. We construct a little table. Okay. Verbs. Adjectives. To the rights. Directs. Soft. Okay, so we have the... This one is intonation change for both of them. And then we have... We have this one for adjectives. So this one is here. Oh man. Why is there a little line below that? I don't want that line there. Oh, this is so weird. Why is there a line now? I have to remove the line. 1 second. Okay, I can't remove the line. Whatever. Table master, eh? Yeah, it always looks a bit messy. I definitely am sorry for that, but in the end result is always a bit better than having nothing at all, I think. Just the way to the end result looks very messy and looks very unstructured and so on, but it's good in the end. Ah, because here is this is underlined, so it's underlined in this one as well. Yeah, I don't like that. I need to remove the underline or I'm not happy. Here, underline. Ah, found it. Nice. Okay. Okay, so what else do we have? Well, nothing. We have the knee. Knees for females mainly. Is this softer as well? Informal way. Okay. Informal for females. No information about the softness. Okay, and also the Simniga, also no information about the softness. So yeah, I guess in the end the table doesn't really make sense when there are only like two different things. Yeah. It's also less direct and sounds a bit nicer. Yeah, I guess. But I can't add the third dimension in this for the gender. So what do we learn in the end? So to make it the most simple for us, so that we don't have to think about adjectives and verbs and so on, we are just always use this one, and we don't have to add anything, we don't have to remember anything, we just use that. And yeah, we sound a little bit harsh and direct, but in the end that's the most simple one, right? Yeah, there will be, yeah, I know exactly, because I think there are more things in the future. That's also a reason why I started this now. We'll see. I have these other tables. Oh, this table is completely messy. This is not good. I definitely have to delete this. This is not good. Yeah, this one also not the best one because, well, yeah, I don't know. But this one is good. This one is definitely good. Yeah, that is good. That's a good table. And this one is very important. This one is also very good. And then those two are just for when I practiced. In the beginning, there was some practicing for the conjugations in lesson 5 and 6. I learned and filled out some tables here. Conjugation and tenses. Yeah. Okay, enough of this. So, we are finished with that lesson. We learned about all the question words. And now, we don't have a practice video, sadly. But we do have the exercise in the workbook, of course. 5,000 levels of softness. Many more levels of softness. Okay. Here's my workbook. We scroll down to lesson 21. Oh, I thought we didn't have an exercise for 21. I thought we just have one for 21 and 22. So then we need to do lesson 22 first. But there is one for just 21 as well. Okay. Okay, let's do it. So I should use a check mark or an X, and I have both of those here. Nice. I have both of the needed symbols. Very good. So use a check mark or X to indicate if the question or answer exchange is natural. Okay, let's we have the answer here for the first one, but let's still understand it. So Pabel Mogot Simniga. Okay, so this is did you eat in a very formal way. Did you eat in a formal way? And the answer is An Mogosimnida. Yeah, that is also the fitting formal, so Simnida, Simniga fits. And the answer is no, I have not eaten. I did not eat. I did not eat. So the formality fits here in both sentences, but then again, maybe you know this, Flo and Kaya. Is there, or can there be a situation where one person is using a formal way to speak, like simida, independent of questions or so, just like any conversation. One person is using a formal conjugation, like simnida, and the other one is not using formal. Is that... That can't happen, right? That's usually not the case. Usually the formality is the same for all conversation partners, right? I want to make a... I want to stress a difference between formality and honorifics. I know that student-teacher, yes, the student talks in a more like high respect way to the teacher, and the teacher doesn't have to talk like that to the student, but the formality is always the same, right? It happens very often between young person or alone. Okay, so I'm not understanding formality. So it looks like from your statements here that there is no difference. Yeah, maybe I just misremembered. The simnida is just a very high respect ending and not a formal ending, right? Okay. In the question lesson, in lesson 21 we just did, the simnida was described as the way for formal situations. But for me, for example, there can be an informal situation, but between a teacher and a student, for example, and the student will still use a very high respect way to talk to the teacher, but it's still not formal. Is that the case, or am I just stupid here? Yeah, I'm not sure. That's what I'm trying to find out, Flo. Maybe I'm just not understanding the concept of formality and respect. I can say to my mom, Simniga, she can answer Mogoso. Okay. Yeah, okay, so I guess there is no difference. And yeah, I don't know. Somehow I misremembered some for some reason. Let me look for one specific thing here. In lesson 6. Here, lesson 6. This is where I was introduced to honorifics, or yeah, to the different conjugations. If you're not formal, you're not respectful. If you're formal, you're respectful. Okay. Okay. Formal high respect, informal low respect, informal high respect. Okay, so formal is always high, but high respect doesn't have to be formal. Maybe we can agree on that. Maybe that's the case. In a formal situation, it's always high respect. There's no other option. But you can use high respect also in an informal situation, which is the yo ending, basically. So that means having high respect doesn't need to be formal. But formal situation needs high respect. Yeah, maybe it's that way. So it's not in both directions exactly the same. But in one direction it is, and in another it's not. For example, this is the same as saying when it's raining, the ground will be wet. Okay, that's always the case. But when the ground is wet, it doesn't have to mean that it was raining. Maybe someone just spilled a drink or so. You know, if it's raining, it's always the ground will always be wet, but if the ground is wet, doesn't have to mean it was raining. So there, maybe it's kind of like that. Like one, yeah, this gets very theoretic, but sadly, I could talk about this in a very. Yeah, that's a problem. I just don't know the real words for that in English. I could talk about this in German so that it's very clear and so on, but in English I'm struggling with that. I'm trying to find the word, but I can't. Doesn't matter. The summary is, if A means B, doesn't have to mean that B means A. Like, it's not always true in both directions. There can be situations where it's only one direction. So if it's formal, it's high respect, but if it's high respect, it doesn't need to be formal. So that's the summary. Okay, I guess we will just continue now. So here we have a formal and high respect. So this one is formal high respect, and so there needs to be formal high respect as well. Okay, next one. All right, wait, I have it. Now I remember. I learned formal not high respect way. That is the plain form, the da form. Yeah, now I have it. Now I have it 100%. Now I know where I remember it from. And I will show you. I know exactly where. What are honorifics? There was a table. So these are the three forms, and then the other form is, here. Plain form. And somewhere it was written that this one is also sometimes called formal low respect form, but he likes plain form more. Yeah, this is where I remember it, right? Okay. Plain. Diary form also used. Okay, we'll continue. Oh yeah, what are the words for these different forms in other resources, in other websites or books? Can you tell me? So let's yeah, so we can agree there are four forms, right? Let's use to go, ka, kayo, kada, and kamnida, right? I mistyped, but you understand what I mean. Can I edit my message? Damn, I can't. So this one is obviously the correct one. But there are... Oh, kanda. Ah, right. Yeah, there's a good reason to avoid this form. Okay, so... So... We do it like this. And we do it again. There we go. Here we have the four forms. Can you tell me the names for those four forms that you know, that you see mostly used in across all the resources that you know? You have learned four forms so far. I think altogether it's seven. Damn. Okay, that's a problem. Okay, maybe we can stay at four for now. Plain. Oh. Okay. Honorific. Plain. But that's only three, Flo. What is what? And where's the fourth one? Differential. I don't know what differential is. Maybe should I go to talk to me in Korean and check it, what it's there? Let me try to talk to me in Korean. Problem is I don't have an account on Talk to Me Korean, so I can't use it or can't show it. Yeah, okay. I will show you what I do on stream. I'm just googling for some other sources where they talk about the different forms. Casual formality, polite low formality, polite high formality, okay? Interesting. Add honorifics to certain. Okay, so here we have different words again. So here we have casual, that also is the same for Kaya here. Low polite, polite low. High polite, polite high, okay. And plain form, okay. Yeah, I know where the forms or where the plain form, for example, is used in newspapers and like print magazines and so on. So it's more like a neutral thing. Yeah, but I mean these names pretty much match to your names, Kaya. Polite low was plain at my uni. So in I mean this is polite low. Yeah, the casual on how to study Korean.com is this one is basically polite low, formal low, polite low, non-formal. Okay, this is polite low for. Okay, this is polite low formality. Polite high form. Okay, but those are both polite, and those are, and this one is casual. Is casual impolite? Yeah, okay, doesn't mean impolite, but I understand. Okay, so casual is not really the opposite, but in this case, in this context, casual is the other option next to polite. So it can be casual or polite, and can be actually I'm not sure. So here they are talking about low formality and high formality, and this is casual formality. So there are three different formalities, and this one is polite, this one is polite, and this one has no information. If we think that the casual is next to low and high formality. Casual, plain, differentiation. Kaseyo. Kaseyo I have not learned yet, so that is not included in the four that I mentioned. Honorific is Simnida, okay. Yeah, okay. We'll just check one more source and then we stop. Basic conjugation according to politeness level. Formal polite, informal polite, casual. So this again fits with the previous source and with Kaya. So just a different order. So casual. Actually, does it? Not low polite and high polite. Not really. Okay, not really. So it's hard. It's hard. Don't worry. We are already over the time, but I will definitely finish the exercise. But I still I still want to do one thing, okay? Okay. High formality, low formality. Actually, let's change that. Okay. And okay. And here we have high politeness, or yeah, maybe also low. I start with low. Low politeness and high politeness. Okay. So this is how I always had it in my head, right? In my head, this was the formality and the politeness both have two different options, high and low. Both of them. So overall we have four options. So for me this was we will use the car. Okay, this is just car. Or maybe let's do it in general. Car or co. Where's the slash on the English keyboard? Certainly not here. Damn it, I don't want to switch every time, but okay. High politeness is the same. Low formality, high politeness. Well, here we have definitely this one. Okay. And then here we had the da ending. Why is it not working? The da ending. And here we have basically this one with yo in the end. Okay. Let's create new words for the levels just for us. Yeah, we can do that. I call everything below Kayo Panmal. And everything above Chun Detmal. I definitely learned some other words in Talk to Me in Korean. When I tried out Talk to Me in Korean, I definitely, like from the very beginning, I learned two words for formal and informal, and those were Korean words as well. Anyways, so this is how I have it in my head. And now we continue with the exercise. Okay, we just continue here. 학교에 갔니? Kanni, right? Double S followed by N is N. N and N. Kanni. Hakyoe kanni. So this is a little bit softer for females, right? Nee. Hakyoe kanni. That doesn't make sense, right? The knee in a non-question gets an X for me. No, no, no. Stop. Okay. Kann nie. Hakyoe kan nie. Yeah, I think this is not only unnatural, this is just wrong. Okay, number three. 그 사람은 여빈가. 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 Okay, so Jobben da is to be pretty. Then we have an N and the K added. That is informal, a little bit softer, right? Informal, a little bit soft. Nee, no mu, arum. Tower요. I think you can add a yo after the car as well. So if it's not used in the question, it should also not be used in the answer, right? For that, to confirm that, I will check it out in our lesson 21. Kayo, yeah, exactly. Here, this one. So you can add the yo to make it more formal. Okay, more formal. Interesting. I thought it's like more high respect. But maybe it's the same. Who knows? This form is less formal than the high respect. Okay. Yeah, but I still stand by my point that if it's not used in the question, it should also not be used in the answer. Or the question is asked by a teacher. But no, I will put an X here. I will put an X. Okay, next one. Murrel. Maschoso. Maschoso. Ma. Sio. Mascho, ja. Murrel. Maschoso. Did you drink the water? Nee. Jinan tare kasoyo. What? Yes. Last month. I go. I went there last month. What? Am I understanding this correctly? Or is this really just an X here? Or am I completely understanding it wrong? Jinan Dare, that is last month. Wait, maybe mashoso. Mashida is to drink, right? Did you drink the water? Or is it to buy or so? No. I think I understand it correctly. Did you drink the water? Yes, I went there last month. Right? Which is wrong, of course. So X. I mean, I was a bit thrown off by the description of the task here. Indicate if the answer is natural. So I thought all the answers and like all the things are correct, but sometimes a bit unnatural. But this is like clearly completely wrong. So I'm a bit thrown off here. But okay, I guess you guys see it the same, so we'll continue. Toni Opsimniga. Toni Opsimniga. Don't you have the money? Don't you have the money? Yeah, I think don't you have the money. Ani, no. Mani Opsimniga. Opsimniga. Also makes no sense as a non-question sentence here. But the translation would be no. I don't have a lot. I don't have much money, basically. So, I mean, at least these fits from a translation standpoint, the sentence and the question, or the answer and the question fit together. But since here is ga in the end, in the answer, that makes no sense. So another X for me. Next one, Chingure Manaso. Chingure Manaso, did you meet your friend? 네, 내일 만날 거예요. Yes, tomorrow I will meet him. I will meet my friend. Yes, I will meet him tomorrow. But did you meet your friend? Yes, I will meet him tomorrow. Makes no sense again, right? It should be no, I meet him tomorrow. Or yes, I have met him yesterday. So another X. We only have X's here everywhere. Okay, next one. 그 영화를 보았니? I'm confused about this yes/no thing, which is it's the opposite in Korean. What do you mean the opposite in Korean? Yes is no and no is yes? That would be confusing. Do you mean specifically this sentence or something in general about yes and no? I think about five should be maybe nay. Ah, okay. Let me see. Don't you have the money? No, I don't have enough. Yeah, I mean that's not a Korean thing specifically, right? It's in the same in English or any other language as well, in German as well. For example, if I phrase a question in a negative way. So, for example, did you not go to school? You can say, and both is correct, both is fine in English and German and so on as well. Yes, I did not go to school, or no, I did not go to school. Both is correct. And yeah, that's just I guess that's just the case here as well. You yes, I don't have much money, or no, I don't have much money is both correct here, in my opinion. I don't like it. I definitely don't like it. If I'm in charge at creating a language, that would definitely not be possible. But that's sadly the case in, but pretty much in every language. Yes and no. In a negatively asked questions, always both correct. Okay. So again here, 그 영화를 보았니? Did you see that movie? Did you see that movie? Asked by a female. In a slightly softer way. 네, 너무 무서웠습니다. 네, okay. Yes, very. I don't know what 무서 is. 무서. You're not going to the party? No, I'm not going to the party. Yeah, but yeah, this is another good example. In English, you can also say, yes, I'm not going to the party. That's perfectly fine. And that's actually what I would use as well. If somebody is asking me, you are not going to the party, I say, yes, you are correct. I'm not going to the party. Yes. But some people also say, no, I'm not going. For me, the yes or no is always yes, your statement is correct, or no, your statement is incorrect. Or the question transformed to a statement. So if the question is, you're not going to the party, I would say, yes, I'm not going to the party. Yes, that is correct. I'm not going. But sadly, in every language, both are correct here. People are using both. Yeah, the thing is, well, I'm pretty sure yes, I'm not going to the party is correct. The yes, it would be correct in English as well. I think in any language, yes, I'm not going to the party. But the thing is, if you have some language book that is saying clearly the rule is this, you have to say yes or no. There's a clear rule. But still, people in the whole country, everywhere, are just using both. Like 50% of the people are using that one, 50% of the people are using that one. It does not matter if there's a clear rule in written in some book. So my way of thinking is, a language is how people speak and not what's written in a book, right? So there's a very, there are two words for that in linguistics. I can't remember the English words that well, but I think one word is a prescriptive. So you define rules and people have to speak that way. And the other one is descriptive. Language is descriptive. So people speak a certain way, and how they speak, that's the language. So those are two different perspectives in linguistics. And in my opinion, the descriptive is the correct one, because it really does not matter if you have a clear rule written in some book, if all the people speak another way. If people speak a certain way that is contradictory to the what's written as a clear rule in a book, then the book doesn't matter. Then the book is useless. Right? language is used by the people and not defined in a book. That's how I think about it. That's also, by the way, why language evolves. If you have just a clear set of rules defined in a book, then language would never change, right? Language would always be static, like the rules in the book. They are always the same and they never change, and that's how it is. But that's not the reality. The reality is language evolve, language change, because people are using the language differently over time. So the rules, which are not really rules, but the definitions of the language, have to be changed according to what people do. So how people speak the language should always be the highest priority and not some rules defined in a book. Okay, but enough of this topic. Yeah, we started with the yes and no. And in my opinion, I would definitely use yes. But I in German and in English, I heard both yes and no used 50% of the time. So it doesn't really matter. Both is correct. So, next one. Did you see that movie? Yes. No, Mu is very. But Musou, I don't know. Can you help me? So here we have the the very common case of a new word in the exercise, I think. Scary. Oh, I think we had that in the last exercise as well, right? But I've not learned it, so I don't know this word. Musopda, okay. Or did I actually learn it? Musopda. I'm not sure actually. I'm not sure if I actually learned it or I just learned it from you for the previous exercise or so. I'm not sure. But okay. Yes, very scary. I guess you can say it was very scary. Simnida. Okay, so I think in general this is a both are correct sentences and they also fit together, the question and the answer. So have you seen that movie? Yes, it was very scary. I think is a fine answer to a question. But the formality doesn't fit. So Simnida is high formality. But ni is low formality, so I would give another X here. Or are you disagreeing? Kaya, you say it's correct. Should be correct. Is there no difference between simnida and ni? I thought ni is less formal. And simnida is very high formality, so it doesn't fit in my opinion. Or am I missing something? We can also check this again. Where's the ni? Here, ni. This is an informal way. Okay, this is here definitely clearly stated informal. And simnida is definitely formal. So I think it should be an X. For me is okay. Okay, so yeah, okay. Flo, you're also saying X. I'm definitely also saying X. How to study Korean is also saying X. But Kaya, you have a different opinion, okay. Ah, formality doesn't have to fit. Okay, but we can agree on that they doesn't fit. So ni is definitely informal and simnida is definitely formal, but you're saying it doesn't have to match. Okay. Okay. We'll see, but since it was so clearly described in the lesson, I think how to study Korean .com's opinion is that this should be an X. But yeah, there's no perfect source of truth, right? But they definitely expect an axia, in my opinion. Okay, so next one. Suyongil Kale Jalheo. Jalheo. Chadada Jalheo. Okay, that should be to cut. Suyong. Wait, what? That is swimming. Is this not Chadada? Well, Jal. Ah, Jalheo, Jalhada. Okay, never mind. Don't correct me in the chat. can you swim well? can you swim well? I think is. Well, do you swim well? But yeah, do you swim well, or are you good at swimming? Let's ask the question in a very natural way. Are you good at swimming? Okay, are you good at swimming? The answer is ani, no. Very, no mu. Bad. There's no space here. Okay. No, I'm very bad at swimming. Okay, so I think the answer fits to the question again, but we have the difference of the yo and no yo. So I would give another X here. I mean, I guess in this case it's even less wrong, because yo and not yo are even closer compared to ni and simnida, I think. But I will still give an X. I think the way Kaya understands this exercise is better because there are too many X. Everything is X. Literally everything except the one that was given. Okay, so we finished the exercise now. Let's do another distinction between definitely incorrect and maybe could be correct. So with that, I will give this one and this one. Okay, we make it a bit smaller here. Like this, yeah. These two can be correct. Let's go through the other ones. This one is definitely incorrect as an answer. This is definitely wrong. This one. This one is definitely wrong because the point of the sentence doesn't fit. Like, have you meet him? Yes, I will meet him tomorrow. Makes no sense. Here we have. That person is pretty. Is that person pretty? Yes, very beautiful. So this is again because of the yo, right? We put an X here because of the yo, so I will put a little check mark here, which could be correct. Then here, what do we have here? Did you drink the water? Yes, I will go there next month. Definitely incorrect. and here we have the knee as part of the answer, which is also definitely incorrect. So this is my final answer for the could be correct answers. 4 is super wrong. Yes. Okay, so 3, 7, and 8. 3, 7, 8. Yeah, okay, so I guess we have the same. So we all agree on this. Yeah, okay. Yeah, I guess we all agree on that, and it doesn't really matter if the answer key is saying X or check mark. probably check mark because we have too many hexes. But I think we all agree on why we put an X there or why we put a check mark there, right? So it's all good. It's all good. But we'll still check the answer key. Okay, and we have 3, 7, and 8. Yes, perfect. Okay. So, the main thing we learn is the conjugations don't always have to fit. That's what I take away from this. If there's a yo in the question, there doesn't need to be a yo in the answer or the other way around. Okay, and with that, this exercise is over. And it's 7:41 already. A lot of discussions, a lot of tables, a lot of other stuff that's not following the usual we read grammar, we do exercise, we do practice video pattern, but it's fine. Okay, so this is the end of today's stream, but let's take a look at what we do next. So the lesson is obviously over now. So the question is, maybe you can give your opinion as well. So we could do lesson 22 next, which is also about questions. So we do the two question lessons right after each other without any gap in between. Or we go through some of the recap, the summary videos for the previous lessons next time. So what do you prefer? Do you prefer immediately doing lesson 22 to have all the questions right after each other without the break in between? Or do you prefer to mix it up a bit and do some of the recap videos? Maybe big review after unit 1 completion. Yeah, we could do that as well. Let's see what we have here. So 22 is again the second question lesson, and then we have colors and the H irregular, before, after, since, within, any, some, very, blah blah blah. Okay. Yeah, okay. I don't mind either way, we can. Yeah, okay, so you both agree on doing the review videos, so the recap videos after 25, right? So, okay, we will start with the vocabulary of lesson 22 then next time. And then we'll do the same structure for 23, 24, and 25. And then we have a nice mini test, and then we'll do all the recap videos from 1 to 25. Okay? We can a whole hour with review videos and discuss anything. Yeah, let's do it. So after this mini test, or maybe even before the mini test. Wait, is there a unit 1 test? Oh, there's a unit 1 test. Oh, this is perfect. Okay, so we will definitely do the lesson 17 to 25 mini test. Then we'll do an whole hour of recap videos from start to finish, 1 to 25, all recaps. And then we'll do the unit 1 test. Okay? Yeah. Yeah, I think that would be a nice way to wrap up unit 1. Okay, but that's still maybe around 1.5 or 2 weeks away, because we still have 22, 23, 24, and 25 ahead of us. Satisfaction intensifies. Okay, perfect. Nice. So, yeah, tomorrow is then the vocabulary of 22, which is... Oh, no, only 35, so that should be done in 2 days, easy. probably easy. Oh, if I see the words some, I had like two different words or three different words for some already. One as in particle, one as for objects, and one for people. Then we have three different for what's. We have some other words that have no connection to any other words that I've learned so far. Okay, so if I look at the words, not that easy, but only 35. So let's see, 2 or 3 days. We'll start that tomorrow. And with that, we are at the end of our lesson. So thanks again for watching and again discussing and yeah, trying to yeah find out all the things that I'm unsure with. And yeah, see you tomorrow. Bye bye, annyeong.